Hello students, good evening all of you. Let us continue discussion of these some important questions from general organic chemistry. It is a very important topic for different type of competitive examinations, and this general organic chemistry includes so many different type of topics. Okay, so in this one here, let us discuss some two numerical questions. The number of hyperconjugated structures for the given ion. Okay, so generally you know that the hyperconjugation is observed in carbocations and alkenes and radicals. Okay, so hyperconjugation, that delocalization of the alpha CH sigma bonding electrons, is observed in carbocations, free radicals and alkenes. Okay, so here carbocation is given. So the number of hyperconjugated structures for the given cation. Okay, so generally in case of the cations, you know this one CH3 here, CH2 plus, this one has a three hyperconjugative structures. So here in this case there is CH2 plus, that means sp2 hybridization, the remaining one p orbital is vacant. So into that vacant p orbital, this CH sigma bonding electrons are delocalized. So CH2 plus, that means here it's a hyperconjugated structure is this one, H plus double bond here, CH2 hydrogen. Okay, by the breaking of this bond here, this carbon gains electrons. So negatively charged carbon here, positively charged carbon, there is a bond formation. So this CH bond, that means here hydrogen loses electrons to the carbon. So this is a hyperconjugated structure. Now here, this type of CH sigma bonding electrons delocalization is possible from either CH bond. That means here, this one has a three hyperconjugative structures. Okay, that has a three hyperconjugative structures. So, but here in this case, here CD3 is given, here there is a CH bond and there is a CT bond also. Okay, of course, this carbon is beta carbon, alpha, beta carbon. Those hydrogens are not involved in a hyperconjugation. Only from the adjacent carbon, CH sigma bonding electrons are delocalized. Okay, so in this delocalization, yeah, generally CD bond also, CD sigma bonding electrons also involved. Okay, that means here these CD sigma bonding electrons also delocalized into the vacant p orbital. Okay, now here, and CT, that means here this one CH2 plus, the CT sigma bonding electrons also delocalized. But here the extent of the delocalization from the CT bond is very less, because that CH bond is a weaker bond and CT bond is a stronger bond. Okay, this is a stronger bond, CH bond is a weaker bond. So CH sigma bonding electrons have a higher tendency to delocalize. Okay, that means here hyperconjugation effect is more, we can see more hyperconjugation effect from the CH sigma bonding electrons, and here very less from the CT sigma bonding electrons. But here CT sigma bonding electrons also involved in a hyperconjugation. Okay, so here we can consider in this case the CD3, three hyperconjugative structures. Okay, here CD bonds are three, and here there is one CH bond and one more CT bond. So here the CT sigma bonding electrons also delocalized. So here this cation has a five hyperconjugative structures. Okay, the five hyperconjugative structure. It is one of the previous question from the National Standard Examination. Okay, there is nothing but NSCC. Okay, this one has a three totally five hyperconjugative structures. Just consider the alpha carbon hydrogens or deuterium or tritium. Okay, that's it. For suppose this is the one previous advanced question, this one. So this one has a how many hyperconjugative structures. Okay, so this one has there is a CH bond here, there are the two CH bonds here, there are the three CH bonds. So totally this one has a six hyperconjugative structures. Okay, it is a 2012 IIT advanced question. So just number of alpha hydrogens, nothing but number of hyperconjugative structures for that cation. Okay, that's it. And next here, the number of aromatic compounds or ions from the given below. Okay, the number of aromatic compounds or ions from the given below. So here in this case, you know that aromatic compounds have a continuous conjugation with 4n plus 2 electrons. n may be 0 or 1 or 2 or 3 and so on. Okay, so here in this case, so generally this boron has a vacant p orbital. This is the sp2 hybridization, there is a vacant p orbital. Okay, so here there is a conjugation into vacant p orbital. That means here there is a continuous conjugation with 4 pi electrons. Okay, continuous conjugation with 4 pi electrons. If a continuous conjugation with 4 pi electrons or 8 pi electrons or 12 pi electrons, that is an anti-aromatic compound. So this is the anti-aromatic compound. Next here, this one again sp2 hybridization, there is a vacant p orbital. So this p electrons, pi electrons can be delocalized, and this pi electrons like this 6 pi electrons are delocalized throughout the ring. Okay, that means it is an aromatic compound. 6 pi electrons conjugation. Okay, so generally we know the tropelium cation. Okay, tropelium cation is also aromatic. Okay, here in this case, this there is a carbon actually. Okay, there is a carbon. So here generally the carbon hybridization is sp2, remaining p orbital is a vacant p orbital. So through that vacant p orbital, this continuous conjugation is possible. The 6 pi electrons are involved in a conjugation. Here in this case, your boron atom here, this one also has a one vacant p orbital. So these 6 pi electrons are involved in a continuous conjugation throughout the ring. So here it is an aromatic one. Now here, the coming to this one, it is a benzyne. Okay, I think most of you know this one. It is a benzyne. Okay, in a benzyne actually number of pi bonds are the 4. Okay, number of pi bonds are the 4. But here in this case, this pi electrons are not involved in a conjugation. Just here, these 6 pi electrons are involved in conjugation. This one also aromatic one. Okay, so because in this case, this pi bond is in the plane. You know that the benzene ring like this. So pi, p orbital, here p orbital, p orbital. Because every carbon hybridization is sp2. So remaining one p orbital on each carbon. So there's a pi bond formation, pi bond formation, pi bond formation. Now here, these pi bonding orbitals are parallel each other. There is a conjugation among the 6 pi electrons. Now here, the remaining p orbital is in the plane actually. The remaining orbital, the remaining one p orbital is in the plane. Okay, that means here in the plane there are the CH bonds. Okay, there are the CH bonds. So here in this case, 12 atoms of the benzene are in the same plane. Okay, now here these two hydrogens remove this one, so that pi bond is in the plane of the benzene ring, so that is not involved in conjugation. The p orbitals which are parallel each other are involved in a conjugation. So that means in the benzyne only 6 pi electrons are involved in a conjugation. Okay, that's it. So next here, coming to this one, here generally here 1 2 3 4 4 pi bonds are in conjugation. That means here 8 pi bonds, but here there is a possibility of the one ring with 6 pi electrons. Okay, here in this ring there is a continuous conjugation among the 6 pi electrons. So here this compound is considered as a aromatic compound. Okay, that means here at least the possibility of the one benzene ring, one aromatic ring, the compound is considered as an aromatic one. Okay, it is also a previous question in a JE advanced examination. So here in this case, sp3 carbon, sp3 carbon throughout the ring, no conjugation. Okay, just here in this ring, in this ring, in the single ring, there is a conjugation of the 6 pi electrons possible. So it is an aromatic compound also. Okay, and now here this is a sp3 carbon, so there is no continuous conjugation. This is a non-aromatic compound. Okay, there is no continuous conjugation, it is sp3 carbon. Now here it is a four member ring and plus two and circle. Okay, it means actually the plus two here circle representation means here you have plus charge, here plus charge, and there is a pi bond. Okay, because here there is a continuous conjugation. Okay, generally we are writing the benzene like this. It is represented with circle. Circle means here there is a continuous conjugation. That means here there is a alternative pi bonds in benzene. Okay, here also plus two circle means here there is a conjugation with two positive charges. So here in this case here pi bond here positive charge, positive charge. Here two pi electrons here there is a throughout the conjugation. Here this one also aromatic ring, aromatic ion. Now in this case it is a cyclooctatetraene. This cyclooctatetraene. tetraene. The cyclooctatetraene is actually anti-aromatic because 8 pi electrons are possible. So from the Huckel's rule, here this one has a 4 n pi electrons, so it must be anti-aromatic, but this one is non-aromatic. Okay, so here in this case, this compound actually has a different shape. This compound has actually a different shape, that is nothing but tub shape. Okay, this is a tub shape. This tub shape is a non-planar. This tub shape is non-planar. In this non-planar shape, there are no continuous conjugation among the four pi bonds. Okay, so that is a non-aromatic compound. Okay, this one is a non-aromatic compound because generally than the anti-aromatic compounds, non-aromatic compounds are more stable. That's why this compound is escaping from the anti-aromatic nature to the non-aromatic nature, because it has a sufficient number of carbon atoms, 8 carbons are there, so that can be converted into non-planar shape to escape from the continuous conjugation. If the continuous conjugation is there in this compound, it must be anti-aromatic, but that has a non-planar shape, there is nothing but tub shape, so there is no continuous conjugation in the cyclooctatetraene, so here finally it is a non-aromatic compound. The interesting point here, there is no conjugation because these p orbitals are not parallel each other. These p orbitals are not parallel each other. That's why no conjugation. So generally you know that the benzene has a same type of carbon-carbon bonds, but cyclooctatetraene has a different types of carbon-carbon bonds. Here double bond, here single bond are completely different. But in case of the benzene, this double bond, single bonds are same because there is a resonance. Okay, so as a result of the resonance here, all carbon-carbon bonds becomes equal. But in a cyclooctatetraene, bonds are not equal because there is no conjugation. That's it. So it has a two types of carbon-carbon bonds here. Benzene has a only one type of carbon-carbon bonds. Its bond length is 1.39 angstroms. Okay, that's it. Now here minus 2 circle means here, this one is the minus 2. Okay, minus 2. Here pi bond, here pi bond, here pi bond. Okay, so in this case 10 pi electrons are there. So it must be aromatic. Okay, it satisfies the 4n plus 2 Huckel's rule, n equals to 2 actually. So here 2 electrons, here 2 electrons, here negative means 2 electrons, here 2 electrons, 2 electrons. So it is an anti-aromatic compound. Okay, it is a non-aromatic. Next here coming to this one. This positively charged nitrogen is sp3 hybridized nitrogen. Okay, that is sp3 hybridized nitrogen. So this sp3 hybridization nitrogen, so has no vacant orbital, so there is no continuous conjugation throughout the ring. Okay, but in this case boron is the sp2 hybridization, there is a vacant p orbital, so throughout the ring there is a conjugation, but here throughout the ring conjugation is not possible, so it is not aromatic. This is a non-aromatic ion. So total number of aromatic compounds from these here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so here 5 compounds or ions are aromatic from the given compounds. Okay, thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel. Please support me. I want to upload daily one video, which are very useful for the JEE main and as well as JEE advanced. Okay, thank you.